One of my favourite deals so far that a group has done was one of the groups had a house already. And what landlords have dealt with in the last couple of years is a massive tax change whereby we can't claim, or we're starting to not be able to claim, mortgage interest relief. So basically we get tax on the gross rent minus maintenance. So 50% of our rent is usually mortgage on average. And all of a sudden that's not a claimable expense anymore. So in the context of dealing with that, the fact that this property hadn't been done up for maybe 10 years, she bought it with a tenant in it. So basically when you do that, you kind of leave them alone. It was their house. This was before buy and rent back got made illegal because there were some big companies doing some really nasty stuff. This lady, she did it ethically. She bought the house, she rented it back to them for a lower rent, and they lived there for years. They didn't really maintain the house. When they did finally leave, through all sorts, they had kind of tragic stuff go on. I think they lost a child, they weren't functioning, you know, very well. They ended up moving, and the house was a complete state. It needed a full refurb. I mean, everything needed doing. I can get you pictures, actually, probably, of that. And the lady was in a position where she didn't have the money to deal with the tax changes or do a refurb, so she would have basically had to sell. So it was worth, I think the mortgage was around 77,000, and she would have just had to go, well, I'll sell it for 77, I'll walk away, at least I haven't lost anything, and she's gained, you know, 10 years or whatever of positive cash flow. And it was right at the time where I was putting a new group together, and so I said, let's look at this deal in the group. One of the guys put 25k in for the refurb. She put the property in. One of the other guys did all of the sort of bookkeeping and keeping receipts and checking of figures and all that kind of thing. One of the other guys did the refurb. And basically they did it together, and they trusted each other to sort of, you know, see it through. They spent about 20,000, 25,000. They were at 77 of a mortgage. They sold it for 140. They made 35, 40 grand, you know, after all the fees and everything. They took that money, which they literally created from what they had. So no one of them individually could have done that deal. And some people go, oh, why would she do that? Why didn't she do it herself? She could have made that 40 grand herself. The reality is she wouldn't. She wouldn't have done it. She didn't have the time to manage the refurb. She didn't have the cash or the resources to pay for it. She couldn't have got a bank loan. And even if she could, she still didn't have the time and the resource. And I think that's when people are making money, they forget that the joint venturing is not just the money. It's the time and the brain power and the planning and the showing up. So they took that 35 grand. They've now bought an HMO, which is a 5-bed HMO, which was ready tenanted. It needs some work, and they'll have maintenance, higher than normal maintenance costs over time, because they're going to do it while people are living in there. But they've instantly got, I think that cash flows between £600 and £800 per month after mortgage, and the mortgage is an allowable expense because they bought it in a company together. So five people came together with effectively not a lot. You know, each of them had a bit of something, and they've walked away making profit, buying a house. So that house that they've now got, the HMO, it's basically like, the returns are infinite, because all of their money's back out, and the money will come in, you know, for the rest of their lives. So that's what happens in joint venture. That's the difference between joint venture and trying to do it on your own. You know, it's magic. And they're now going on to buy, you know, their next deal.